What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy D, and I am back with another video. And in today's video, I'm going to give you an update on my 2JZ motor rebuild. But first, I need you guys to bear with me. I forgot my wireless audio equipment at home. I knew I forgot something before I came out here, but unfortunately, you're just going to have to deal with the crappy audio coming straight out of my phone. Let's talk about what's going on here. If you didn't watch my last video, I recommend you go ahead and watch that, because in that video I explained what happened to my 2JZ motor. But in this video, I am going to walk you through the rebuild process and everything I'm doing to rebuild this motor. So everything back here on this table is everything that I've been collecting for the rebuild, all the forged internal parts. The 2JZ motor is coming back stronger and better than ever, guys, and I'm excited to share it with you. So check it out, guys. My Sephiro is just sitting under the car cover, covered in dust. Soon she'll be brought back to life, but for now she's just resting under the cover. She'll wake up soon. So let's go over to the table full of parts and let me show you what I've been collecting over the past 2 or 3 months. It has been taking a while, and the reason for that is because none of this stuff is cheap, guys. This is really high quality forged stuff. So let's get to it. Alright guys, so the first thing that you're going to notice on the table are the Forge BC rods. These are really high quality rods. These are actually the rods that were already in my motor. So we are going to reuse the rods. They're in really good shape. These rods are really high quality. Again, these are the Brian Crower H-Beam Forge rods. And one thing you'll notice is that we got stock pistons on them. That's right, guys. When I bought the motor, I didn't know much about the internals because I don't know who the engine builder was, and the owner before me didn't know who the engine builder was. So I was told that the engine had BC rods and CP pistons, but we were wrong. These are actually stock 2JZ pistons, which is kind of weird. I don't know why you would upgrade the rods but keep stock pistons. That's kind of weird to me. So anyways, we are going to keep these 6 BC rods, and then as you can see right here, I went with Diamond Racing pistons. These are really high quality pistons made in America, so you know the quality is going to be good. So, and I only took one of them out of the packaging because they all basically look the same. You guys can pretty much see. Look at the design, the skirt coating, pretty good feel to it. Has like a nice slippery feel to it, so when it slides up and down the cylinder walls, doesn't have as much friction, so that translates to less heat. And inside you can see the design and all the oil pins and everything. Really nice design pistons on these. And of course the specs on these. So I went with an 86.5 bore with a compression ratio of a 9.1:0. So not too far off from stock, but a little bit more aggressive, which is fine because I'm going to be running E85 and E20 fuel out here anyways. And of course all the wrist pins and the clips are all in there, the full set. So that'll do it with the pistons. Actually, my first choice was to go with CP pistons, but they were out of stock and they told me I had to wait a good 4 to 6 weeks. So I wasn't about to wait 4 to 6 weeks for pistons when these were already available off the shelf. So not too bad. These are really high quality, so I'm happy with it. All right, moving on. So of course we got ACO race bearings, both the main bearings and the rod bearings, and of course we got brand new thrust washers to help keep the crank in place. And then over here we got a brand new Toyota OEM oil pump. All the auxiliary stuff is also being upgraded, or at least being replaced with brand new stuff. This is one of the very few auxiliary items that were never replaced on my motor, so it's a good idea to just go ahead and get a brand new one. And also the old one was part of the reason why the engine failed, so got a brand new oil pump. Now, moving on. This is the billet timing gear from Powerhouse Racing, made in America. Very high quality piece. This is actually one of the reasons why the motor failed, is because the stock piece failed. And I'm just gonna put it side by side to the stock one so you can see the difference. All right, guys, so we got the brand new billet piece right here. And then of course, this is the stock one right here. So as you can see, it kind of disintegrated into two pieces. And when that happens, the timing is all off and basically your timing is all out of whack. So with this really solid billet timing gear, we should not have any issues going forward. So very happy with this piece. All right, moving on to the next piece, we got a billet timing belt tensioner bracket by Powerhouse Racing, made in the USA. Really high quality bracket piece right here. And you might be asking, why would you upgrade this? The reason being is because this aftermarket piece has a bronze bushing inside, which allows for more flexibility for tensioning. And of course, I got the brand new OEM bolts and washer to go with that. The reason why you want to upgrade the bolt is because over time these can start to rust, and if this starts to rust and gets stuck in the hole here, that can really seize up your engine. So very important that you have a good condition bolt. Moving on, we got billet main caps. Also, this is also a part of the reason why the engine failed. So I'm just going to take out one of these billet main caps. You can see how heavy, well, you can't see, but I can tell you this is extremely heavy, just one piece. And these are made out of billet aluminum, super strong. These are capable of over 1500 wheel horsepower, probably more than that. I think there's a lot of 2000 wheel horsepower cars, drag cars in America that use these billet main caps. So it's definitely overkill for anything that I'm trying to do on my car. But it's one of those things, while you're in there, you might as well go ahead and replace it, because I don't want to put factory main caps back in there. And if you guys remember, I had 3 main caps fail on me. So I'm going to put this side by side with one of the factory main caps. Look at that, guys. We got the billet main cap right here, and we got one of the factory main caps on top. As you can see, the main cap's cracked, completely cracked in half. And it didn't happen to just one, it happened to 3 main caps. So those were done. These will probably never break unless you're doing like consistently over 2000 wheel horsepower drag racing runs like nonstop. So, and another thing I like about these Real Street main caps is that they label it from 1 through 7, and with the arrow showing you towards the front of the engine. So 1 through 7, very high quality parts. These are very overkill, but definitely a must. I definitely didn't want to put factory main caps back in the car. And of course, when you upgrade to the main caps, you definitely want to upgrade your main bolts. So these are ARP main stud bolts, very high tensile strength. Comes with all the washers and the bolts, or excuse me, the head caps, the screws, whatever you want to call it. Comes with some lubricant. Definitely want to upgrade those as well with the billet main caps. All right, so moving on, I'm going to show you everything that's in this box that is pretty much boring but very much necessary, and you don't want to skip on this. But first, let me clear this table. So what do we have in the box? Let's start off going from left to right. So starting off, we got the OEM Toyota rear main seal. Very important that you replace this. I don't know when was the last time the rear main seal on this engine was ever replaced, so we're gonna replace it. Same goes with the front main seal. This goes right here onto the oil pump, and the billet timing gear goes right on top of that. So definitely want to replace the front main seal as well. These two right here are the camshaft seals that go on the camshafts. If you guys remember, I'm using HKS 272 degree cams. And these are just random OEM Toyota O-rings for the water pump, the oil pump, underneath the engine. Basically, every single gasket or leak that I had on this motor is going to be alleviated with every single seal. Just trust me, there's going to be no more leaks on this engine. Everything is going to be sealed with brand new rubber, brand new gaskets all over the entire motor. And just for the hell of it, I got a brand new crank bolt pulley. The one that was on my car previously was super tough to pull off the bolt pulley, so I figured, why not? They're not that expensive. Let's just get a brand new crank pulley bolt, so it'll just go right there into the timing belt gear, right on the snout of the crankshaft. That's that. And then moving on to the ground over here, of course, we got a brand new OEM Toyota head gasket. I don't want to take it out because these things are very fragile. I'm going to just leave it in the cardboard box. You guys should know what a a head gasket looks like. And of course, right here, we got a brand new 2JZ timing belt cover. I just got this for the hell of it. It's just one of those things that if you look at these covers over time, they kind of get worn out and just kind of look kind of nasty. They look faded. The black plastic gets really gray. They're not that expensive, so I might as well just get a brand new one. And of course, we got a brand new oil pan. You guys may have seen me talk about this oil pan in a previous video, but we ended up not actually installing it. What we did was we just used the old oil pan because the oil pan actually wasn't the issue. The oil was leaking somewhere else. I think it was like a silicone leak, but it wasn't related to the oil pan. But nonetheless, I just told them, let's just throw on the new oil pan while we got the motor out. And to go with the brand new oil pan, we got this pretty cool, genuine, gritty oil drain plug. This goes right there. So yeah, guys, that pretty much does it for the rotating assembly. The brand new rotating assembly, lower engine. Everything is forged. Pistons, rods, billet pieces, all the OEM gaskets and seals, race bearings, billet main caps. Man, I'm excited, guys. All the saving I've done to buy all this crap, it was a lot of money, don't get me wrong, but I'm super excited to get the car back on the road and have some fun. Alright guys, so I just put everything away back in the storage room. Let's just give you guys a quick walkthrough here. So here's everything else that's pulled off of my car. Aluminum radiator, plastic under tray, bunch of the older parts like the old oil pump and everything. Here you can see my HKS camshafts and HKS cam gears. Basically all the belts and everything. And under here, under the pistons box, is the head, which is pretty much going to be remained untouched. So there's nothing wrong with the head. As far as I know, the head is pretty much stock other than the camshafts. What's the next step, guys? So I've got all the parts. The next step is... stay tuned, because the next step is to actually get this motor built, all right? So I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out.